These are 5 of the best note-taking apps for Android. We are only gonna cover handwritten note-taking apps on this video. And this is the part 1 of the video. We'll feature more apps in the part 2. My name is Prithviraj and I create videos on productivity, tech and life. If you have a Samsung tablet like myself, simply try out Samsung Notes. It's like a perfect blend of an app. Samsung Notes excels in both text-based as well as handwritten notes. It has all the necessary tools that you require. As you know, Apple Notes is the biggest rival of Samsung Notes. But Apple Notes is only good at text-based note-taking. And also the organizational system is really well. Handwritten notes aren't really the best on Apple Notes. You can't even zoom inside them. But here on Samsung Notes, the handwriting experience was much more superior in comparison with Apple Notes. The best part about Samsung Notes is the fact that since it's a default app by Samsung, it's basically free and you never have to pay for any subscription whatsoever. Unlike many other apps that we're gonna feature in this video. Talking about the app itself, Samsung have created a very powerful note-taking app. It basically covers everything you need to create and organize your notes. We are able to create and organize our notes into different folders, and also we can create subfolders to micromanage our notes. You can import PDFs into Samsung Notes and directly take book notes over here. But something I need to point out is that if you import a large PDF inside Samsung Notes, it often starts to lag. This thing basically depends on the device that you're using, to be honest. As I didn't face such lags on my Samsung Galaxy Tab S9, whereas while using it on my Galaxy Tab S9 FE Plus, it did struggle a bit. So keep that in mind. Ignoring that, the writing experience is really nice on this app. You can also convert your handwritten notes into text using this app, but it's like a hit or miss, to be honest. It's not very accurate. But the biggest limitation of Samsung Notes is that it's Samsung Notes. You will never be able to use it if you have a Xiaomi tab or a OnePlus tab. That brings us to the next app, which is Microsoft OneNote. Thankfully, this is another free app. And the thing that I like the most about Microsoft OneNote is its organizational system. With OneNote, you can create notebooks, sections, and pages to keep everything neatly organized. Just take a look at the folder system. You can color code each folder and maybe organize them as per your different subjects or projects of yours. Then you can create different pages here and manage your stuff accordingly. The organizational system is super clean because of this. We get a lot of pen options to choose from and adjust the color, sizes and stuff like that. The handwriting experience was also great inside OneNote. Writing here felt very natural, although I faced a bit of issues regarding the palm rejection aspect at times. Like it creates this weird dots because of my palm touching on the screen, but luckily it wasn't that often. But since it happens at time, I thought I should mention that as well. Another aspect where OneNote excels is that you can simply drag and drop your text from web. Like take a look here. I have this window opened up on my browser in the split screen mode, that is. Now I can simply select the text I require and then just drag and drop it over onto OneNote. This thing is a very helpful addition. It can make your life so much easier. Also, there is an option to add voice recordings into your notes if that's something you might require. But the real game changer of OneNote is that it's a true cross-platform app. You can literally access this in every single device. Android, iOS, Windows, as well as macOS. Very few apps offer such a cross-platform sync. However, one major drawback I want to point out, it can really be slow at times. It can take a while to load up your notes. And if you have ADHD, then that can really become annoying at times. Like, take a look for yourself. It's taking a brief moment to actually load up my notes, so yeah, I thought I should point that out. Also, we are very close to hitting 100k subs on this channel, so I'd really appreciate if you could hit that subscribe button. Would definitely help me out a lot. If you're into academic research or love working with detailed documents, in that case, Flexel is the app for you. This app is a unique blend of PDF reader and a note-taking tool. It has this unique way to categorize your notes and PDFs. We have this dedicated toggle to switch between PDFs and notes, so if you happen to work a lot with PDFs, then this is the ideal app for you. As you can see, when we open the app for the first time, we get a lot of demo PDFs to check out. And not to worry, we can further categorize our notes and PDFs by creating folders. So yeah, that's a helpful addition. Now, when we create a new note, we get this option to choose from different notebook covers, and they have a wide variety of covers. No matter if you like minimal covers or something more colorful, there is something for everyone. So you can truly customize your notes and make it your own. And not to forget, we also have a lot of page layouts to explore from, like rule, dotted, graphs, etc. Now, getting into the note-taking aspect, the toolbar above is very minimal. We get all the pen options once we tap on the pen button. We don't have those quick toggles here like many other apps. It's not a deal breaker, just that you have to make a few extra clicks to get your pen options. So if you have to toggle between different tools and pens, then this can add up. The writing experience here felt very smooth, and unlike Microsoft OneNote, I didn't face any issues in the palm rejection aspect as well. Everything was spot on while taking notes. You can add a text block inside your notes in case you wanted to add some text to your notes. Another cool thing about Flexel is that, for example, we have this PDF opened. Now you can simply tap on this icon and it will open up a new quick note in a floating window. Now you can simply long press on the text you want to select and drag and drop it into the floating window that we have. From there, we can work on that directly. super clean. This app runs on a freemium model, as in you can use this app for free, but many features of this app is behind a paywall, as in you'll have to get the premium subscription for that. Many things like templates and digital planners and stuff like that are behind this paywall. However, if you're interested in digital planning, then check out the template that I created myself. You can simply import your PDF into your favorite notes app and then get started into daily planning. It has three different views, daily, weekly, as well as for monthly planning, and also two different color themes, both for light mode as well as dark mode, so you can pick anyone you like and get started. I highly recommend that you try out daily planning. It will really help you stay much more productive and accountable, and in the end help you achieve all your daily goals. As by doing this, you won't have to worry about what to do next in the middle of the day. You will have a clear plan laid out for you, and also if you choose to get my template, then you'll be directly supporting my channel, and that would mean a lot to me. If not, you can simply use a notebook or any notes app for that. But do try planning for your day. This will really help you check off your to-do list each day. Next up, we have Notewise. This is a hidden gem that has been gaining traction lately. This app takes your writing experience to the next level. I previously created a dedicated review on this app. It's that good. If you have previously used GoodNotes 6 on your iPad, then the layout of Notewise will feel very similar to that of GoodNotes. Everything is laid out right in front of you on the top bar. We have quick toggles for everything we need, from pen options to pen sizes to the color. This will really help you speed up your workflow while note-taking. You will be able to organize your notes into different notebooks, and also you can import the PDFs of your books and insert photos in this app. The writing here simply felt much more natural. Everything was responsive, and I didn't face any issues regarding the palm rejection aspect or even the latency here in Notewise. You can also split screen multitask between two different notes here in Notewise. This can make your life easy if you wanted to compare two notes side by side. This app has a very unique feature that I need to point out, and that is real-time collaboration. If you often have to work on a note with someone, like you have a team or your partner, then this app allows you to work on a note real-time just like Google Docs. But the cherry on top is that we can do the same with handwritten notes. Here's an example. As you can see, whatever I'm doing on my Samsung tablet is getting updated on my iPad real-time. This feature is insane. Hence, if you need to work on handwritten notes with a partner or something like that, then this app is the one for you. It again has a freemium model. I guess you can create up to 3 notes in the free version. You have to get the premium version to make the most out of this app. Final pick for this video is JNotes. I really like the interface of JNotes. It's really sleek and intuitive. Its clean design ensures that you focus entirely on the content without distractions, and I really like that. Simplicity is often the most important trait of any note-taking app. But before we talk about the app itself, I would like to discuss the writing experience on this app. There is a slight latency where the writing experience is concerned. If you take a look very closely, you will be able to see that. But this can actually turn into your favor. If you prefer a more calm and slow writing experience so that you can focus more on your handwriting, then this thing can actually be helpful for you. But in case you prefer writing really fast, then this will be more of a hindrance, so you should keep that in mind. This app actually offers a lot of options. You can even change the pressure sensitivity of your pen. You can add photos and stickers in this app. But one thing I really liked is that it has a to-do list segment built inside this app. So if you wanted an all-in-one app, then this app can actually be beneficial in that aspect. You can even add audio recordings inside JNotes if that's something you might need. And of course, we can import PDFs inside this app and take book notes. However, there is no free version of this app, unfortunately. We get a 30-day free trial, but after that, we have to get the subscription. Click here to check out the part 2 of the best note-taking apps for Android. Don't miss out, as we have discussed about more such cool apps over there.